Hey everyone, how's it going? Joe Lorendi here with Fandemonium. A special day with a lot to talk about. Hope everybody is enjoying their Saturday. We are just about a month away from the draft, and it just seems like that's what everybody wants to talk about right now is the draft. How are we going to get up there? As you can see from what I posted, what we're talking about today is the Bills are moving up. I am fully on board saying the Bills are moving up in the draft. What we're going to try to figure out today, how are they going to do it? Who are they going to trade with? Where are they going to go? That's what we're going to try to figure out and solve all the different options that the Bills have to move up in this year's draft. It's the hottest topic, and everybody's wondering, even the national media, how nice is it to have the national media sit here and say, oh, where are the Bills going to go? What are the Bills going to do? The Bills are the biggest player in this year's draft. It's kind of fun to watch. Finally, for like the first time in a while, we are the center of attention in the NFL world. It's a nice relief, and it's something new and something we haven't felt in a long, long time. So let's just dive right into it. Of course, we have to start with the biggest news, which I talked about last week on last week's show with last week's Fandemonium, talking about the Jets that happened on Friday night. I got it on Saturday morning and broke it down. The Jets moving up to number three. And that's huge. That's huge. And that's where we need to start today. So let's just recap so everybody knows where we're going with this and where the Jets were. So moving up from six to three. This is what they had to give up. Just a little recap for everybody at home. So for them to move up three spots to the third spot in the draft, they had to give up obviously their first round pick and three second round picks, two in this year's draft, and one in 2019. A big amount for them to have to move up just three spots. So now we have the Jets at number three. That's big for the Bills, obviously. So how is Brandon Bean in this front office going to respond to a move like that? That's yet to be seen. And it's the question that everybody's trying to figure out. Obviously, in my opinion, as you can see from my post and what I put in describing today's show, I obviously think they are moving up. Let me repeat that again. They are moving up. And let me tell you why. There's a couple of clues and red flags that say, absolutely, the Bills are moving up in this year's draft. I don't think there's any doubt about it. Let's look at it, the facts right now. This Bills team and Brandon Bean have just stacked up on draft picks. They're going to get their quarterback this year. There's no doubt about it. I don't think I'm breaking any news to anybody out there. They want their quarterback. They've been setting up for this for the past year. This is what they've wanted. This is what they're waiting for. They're not going to go without getting their guy, the one that they want to be their quarterback next year. But there's also some other clues besides all the trades and all the draft stocks that, and all the stocks and draft picks they've compiled over this past year. Let's look at this year's, at this offseason that's happening right now. Look at the pickups that they have. A lot of veterans who are going to plug holes over the next year and the year after that. Why? Obviously, you want your veterans on your team. They don't hurt anybody to have veterans there and to help out your locker room. But also why? I think that Brandon Bean knows that he's going to have to trade a lot of his draft picks in order to move up in the drafts. So what does that mean? A lot of those holes, a lot of those problem areas that have plagued the Bills, those are pretty much settled for at least another year or two until they get past all the draft picks that they got rid of and to get those back and then can draft those spots in the draft and fill when those veterans get off. So what they're doing this offseason, they're just simply plugging holes with veterans because they know they're not going to have those picks in the draft. So with that being said, I think those are the two very obvious things that the Bills are going to move up. But like I said, I started off with where and how are the Bills going to move up. And I think there's a couple of scenarios, and I think there's something that people really aren't talking about. And that is when you look at this year's draft board, you look at it and you have the 12 teams. Obviously, I'm talking about the Bills at 12 right now. There's actually a decent amount that don't need a quarterback that you know aren't picking a quarterback. Let's go through them right now. Well, obviously, we'll go back from 12 up to 1. Obviously, the Bills drafting at number 12 in this year's draft. At 11, the Miami Dolphins. Now, I know some of this is up for debate, but I think the Dolphins are going to pass on a quarterback this year. Ryan Tannehill coming off an injury, I think they're going to give him one more season. He was showing that he could possibly take the next step, and I think he's going to be able – I think they're going to give him another chance in Miami, at least not draft a quarterback with their top pick. I think that'd be irresponsible for the Dolphins to go ahead and do that. And I think you're really throwing Ryan Tannehill to the curb if you're going to do something like that. So I don't expect the Dolphins to go quarterback. At number 10, the Oakland Raiders. Raiders got Derek Carr. They aren't picking a quarterback. At number 9, the 49ers, Jimmy Garoppolo. It's going to be a pretty damn good quarterback there. They're not picking a quarterback, so there's another one that's not going quarterback. At 8, the Chicago Bears just traded up last year to get Mitchell Trubisky. You better believe they're not picking a quarterback. Moving on, number 7, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers have Jameis Winston there. Maybe could go somebody later in the draft, but I just don't see them picking with the 7th overall pick a quarterback when you have Winston there. So there's another position. So just right there, I think you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 positions all the way from 7 to 11 that aren't going to go quarterback. Moving on, Colts at number 6, they have Andrew Luck there. Yes, I know the shoulder is a concern, but I don't think that's going to be – I don't think they're going to waste a draft pick on a quarterback that early. Broncos at 5. This is where it starts to get interesting and where you may see the chess pieces start to fall, where the Bills need to get in front of in order to move up there. And I'm actually seeing a lot of you say Dolphins will take a quarterback. I'm really interested to see why everyone thinks Miami's going quarterback at 11. I'll get back to the Colts and the Broncos in a little bit. How? With Ryan Tannehill there, who I know got injured, and I know the injury is a concern, but you think with their first pick overall that Miami doesn't have other places they need to go and have two quarterbacks there? I just think it'd be irresponsible. I don't think they're going to go quarterback. They might go later in the draft, possibly in the second round. I just don't see with their first pick sitting at 11. I think there's a lot more talent out there and more areas that they could fill instead of drafting a quarterback. I really don't think Miami's going quarterback, but I know I'm kind of in the minority in that opinion. I just don't understand why. And I'm seeing in the comments that people really think the Dolphins are going to go quarterback. I don't think they're going quarterback, but apparently you guys do. But anyway, might be a place where the Dolphins need to go. And Tannehill has never done anything in this league. A good point, but I still think they gave him that contract. I still think they believe in him. I think it's easy to sit there and say he obviously hasn't done anything, and I think that's you're right in that comment, but I think they're going to give him at least another year. Let's hope as Bills fans that they give Ryan Tannehill another year under center in Miami. I'm also seeing some comments that some people think the Colts are going to go quarterback with the 6th overall pick. Come on, people. No, I know Andrew Luck has the bad shoulder, but once again, could you imagine them bringing in a quarterback with the 6th overall pick with Andrew Luck there? Come on, let's think about this. There's no way that's going to happen. It's Andrew Luck's team. Until he proves that his shoulder might not be healthy and he's not the guy anymore, I don't think they're going to do anything in order to mess that up. I just don't think that's something Frank Reich wants on his plate as a first-year head coach, going in there with a QB battle between somebody you've set your franchise. You got rid of Peyton Manning. You're not gonna just throw him right to the curb just because he had a shoulder injury. No way. Stop with that nonsense. So let's go back to the draft order. I kind of disputed the Dolphins and I kind of disputed the Colts. That's just my opinion. Feel free to comment and tell me why I'm wrong, but I think I'm right on those. So let's go to the Broncos. And really interesting case there of what is going to happen. You have Case Keenum, who they just signed. Do I think the Broncos actually think that Case Keenum is the future there in Denver? No. Can he start next season and maybe the next? Absolutely. No doubt about that. But they also drafted Paxton Lynch just a couple years ago. Is John Elway going to go and take on another quarterback with the fifth pick? It's a possibility. I don't think anybody's ruling it out. We'll see what happens. I could see the Broncos are a real question mark to me on where they're going to go. I could see them. I wouldn't be surprised if they took one, and I kind of wouldn't be surprised if they wouldn't, if they just said, we'll get one later, especially with the two quarterbacks in Case Keenum and Paxton Lynch. And I know Paxton Lynch hasn't impressed all that much, but I think Denver is a bigger question mark than people think. We'll see what happens with Denver. So moving up again in the draft board, the Browns at number four. That's an interesting pick, depending on who they go with number one. I think it all but solidified. It was a question mark before the draft. Where was Cleveland going to pick Barkley, maybe number one, or someone at number one, and then get their quarterback at number four? With the Jets moving up to three, it all but solidified that the Browns are going quarterback at number one. So moving on to the Jets at number three, obviously the Jets are going to go quarterback. Let's just stop with that. At number two, the New York Football Giants. Man, did they just become an interesting pick. Where is this team going? What are they going to do? The reports are all over the place. I've heard some that say Eli Manning is their quarterback just for the next year or two. Gettleman believes in him, and they're just going to find a way to possibly win over the next two seasons. I've heard reports that they are going to blow it up there in New York, that this is enough. They stink, and it's time to restart. I have no idea what the Giants are going to do. Are they going to trade out? Do they want to stay? I've heard both reports. I have no idea what to believe. I have absolutely no idea who's right, who's wrong, what's going to happen. But I know one thing. The Bills are at least going to make the call to them to see if they can move up to number two. We'll talk about that in a little pick. But the Giants pick after the Jets moved up just became – it was interesting before, but it just made it the talk of the draft leading up. Are the Giants staying? Are they picking a quarterback? Are they trading out? We'll see what happens. And, of course, at number one – you have the Cleveland Browns, who are obviously going quarterback, but I've also once again heard reports that there's teams calling. Would the Browns trade out of number one? I would think no. I think there's absolutely no way that the Browns would trade out of that spot. You have an 0-16 team. Get your quarterback. Enough is enough, Cleveland. Stop messing around. But this is Cleveland we're talking about. They've done some stupider things over their lifetime. And who knows? I'm not going to rule it out as a possibility. So let's go through that again, and let's talk about where can the Bills move up to? Where are the possibilities? One and two, I think obviously two is much more probable than number one. But I think if Brandon Bean, I'm a big believer in, if we're trading up, if the Bills are going to move up, they want to get their guy. And I'm just seeing Pierre come in here and comment. We'll go back to this in a sec. The Gettleman, and they like their rookie QB last year. There's just so many reports. We'll see what happens, but I agree. They might like their rookie quarterback and just stick with him and see what happens. But once again, going back to Browns Giants, can we move up to one or two? I think if you're a Bills fan, you want the, if you're moving up and selling the farm, which they're going to have to do, we'll talk about that in a little bit. If you're going to give up so much to move up there, you want to get your guy, the guy that you want. If do you want to trade up, let's say they do it 2 weeks from now, 2 weeks before the draft, and they really wanted, for example, Josh Rosen, and Rosen goes first overall. So you just gave up the farm and you didn't get the guy that you want. Don't you want the Bills to move up to number one and get the guy that they want, that they believe in, is the future of this franchise? I'm all for this thing of going to number one over number two, if that's a possibility. It sounds like, once again, reports that they are trying, that the Browns are saying no. Who knows? But I'm a big believer in let's see, go get the guy and make sure that he is there and you can take him. So how else do you guarantee that your guy is going to be there if you can't move up to number one and the Browns say, no, we're keeping that pick? In my opinion, it got to wait till draft day and see how the draft falls. You can watch the Browns take their pick, see what quarterback they take. Once again, we'll just stick with the Rosen example, not saying that's my guy. We'll get to that in a little bit. If they take Rosen and the Bills really wanted Rosen, then they're not. Then I don't think it's worth moving up for if you don't get your guy. So you have to wait till draft day in order to see who the Browns are actually going to take and if it's worth moving up all the way up there. So, you know, we'll see what happens there. I'm a big draft day believer. Wait till that team's on the clock, see the draft board, and then go from there. So I really hope, actually, if the Bills do make a trade, they do wait till draft day to see how it works out. So 1 and 2 are obviously up for play, and if you want to get in front of the Jets, that's the biggest thing. But let's see what happens. Let's say unexpected things happen every single year in the draft, things that nobody ever predicts. Go look at mock drafts every single year from Mel Kiper 2 days before the draft. It's laughable. None of them ever get it right. So it's so unpredictable. It's like the NCAA tournament. Who had Loyola Chicago going into the Elite Eight? It's just like, we'll see what happens in this year's draft, but there's something that's going to go that you're not going to expect to happen. So let's see. Maybe there's that whole cluster of teams from 6 to 11, in my opinion. I know a lot of you seem to disagree with that. But let's say somebody falls into that area, maybe a Baker Mayfield that they really like, or I think Sam Darnold really's stock is really rising as of after his pro day. But Sam Darnold, somehow, one of them is going to have to fall out of that top five. There's just too many quarterbacks there for not one of them to come back in the draft. Maybe the Bills can save a couple of their picks and just move up to 7 or 8 and guarantee that they get their guy. But that whole cluster from 6 to 11, nobody needs a quarterback. I know a lot of you think the Dolphins are going quarterback, but I don't think so. But I could see without a doubt, let's say somebody expected, let's say Rosen falls out of the top five. I could see the Bills maybe moving up to number 6 with the Colts, going to grab their guy, and that's that. And they save some of their picks instead of selling the farm before the draft. But those are the different at least spots that they can go. And I don't think people realize how little of teams actually need quarterbacks in the top 10. How many that are actually, it's actually possible. I think the Bills are in a really good position at 12, and even just to move up maybe a couple of positions if they need to, but they may not need to go all the way up to 1 or 2 in front of the Jets. I hope they wait till draft day. But the other thing that I hope, let's say they're just in love with Josh Rosen, then by all means, go up and get your guy. I will also support that too. And one thing I've seen a lot of people say, bring up A.J. McCarron is an interesting character in all of this. I think most of us were expecting, I know I said on the first Fandemonium that Rosen was, or I'm sorry, that the Bills were going to go with a veteran quarterback and get their rookie and let the rookie learn under this veteran. Maybe the veteran would start next year. But that doesn't all but seem to be happening with the pickup of A.J. McCarron. I think a lot of people believe in McCarron and at least want to give him a chance. They want to see what McCarron can do. And I kind of like it as a Bills fan, having that guy, a little mystery guy. He kind of reminds me, not the way he plays quarterback, but reminds me of Tyrod Taylor. It's kind of that same situation. Somebody who got some time, you have a little bit of stats, kind of a high ceiling, but also a low basement. We don't really know what we're getting with McCarron. Nobody's given him a chance to actually succeed in this league. Could he turn out to be something good or not? I'm not exactly sure. I'm not a huge believer in A.J. McCarron. But it's an interesting person to have on your roster. Somebody who has question marks, who could either be better than expected, or there's also possibly worse than expected. So we'll have to see what happens there with McCarron. But I see a lot of love for AJ McCarron right now coming in from the comments. So I wanted to address that to say that I'm not exactly on the McCarron believers bandwagon, but I definitely see parallels between his career and Tyrod Taylor's career, not in the way that they play quarterback, but in the way that they kind of had a little bit of a chance. You got to see a little bit. Maybe with a chance, they could really excel. Obviously, that's what I'm cheering for, but we'll see what happens with that. So it's getting so interesting. So let's say, obviously, I have the Bills moving up in the draft. I would be very surprised if they actually moved up to one or two. I think it's a lot to give up, and they're going to have to give up the farm. But let's say they do move up to one and two. What are the Bills sacrificing? There's going to be a lot. You better believe they plugged some of these holes in free agency, but I know they would love to have some rookie talent along with these veterans there too. So a pass rusher, obviously, as we know, I mean, the defense was pretty good last year, but was terrible at rushing the quarterback. There's just no other way around saying that. Obviously, they got Trent Murphy, who's a question mark. He had a very good season in 2016, I believe toward the ACL, or had a season-ending injury in 2017. We'll see what happens, but I know the Bills would love to add a pass rusher along in that mix, because obviously I don't think Shaq Lawson is working out for us all that great. Has done really absolutely nothing in his a couple seasons here in Buffalo, and I think they want to get somebody else. Linebacker, obviously, we lost Preston Brown. We do have some young talent and some veteran talent, but it never hurts to be able to go maybe grab a second or third round linebacker. I would totally expect them to draft one of those if they were able to hold on to those picks. Another key position, and it might have just even got a little bit more slim, wide receiver is dismal right now. Calvin Benjamin, who hopefully will be healthy, completely healthy next season. We'll see what happens. But when he is healthy, he's a great wide receiver, but you definitely need some other targets around him. Zay Jones, I won't even get into what happened the past couple of days. Hopefully everything's all right with him. We're cheering for him here at Buffalo Fanatics to get better. But to putting that aside, just assuming that he is fine to start the season, Zay Jones was, I think, very disappointing to a lot of Bills fans this season, including myself. We were expecting him to do a lot, and he still might. He showed a little bit every once in a while, like he could be a decent wide receiver, but not enough to have me really convinced of anything yet. But right now, he sits as your second wide receiver on this team. Let that sink in, Bills fans, and expect them to try to find a wide receiver in this year's draft. If there's one good thing about the wide receiver position, I think it's one of the easiest positions to fill in the NFL. There's wide receivers all over the place. I'm not talking elite wide receivers, of course. Those are hard to come by. But you can plug people in and find ways to win football games. You see it every single week from teams. So that's the good news with wide receiver. But the Bills are on thin ice at the wide receiver position. And then also another one that if you were to sell the farm and move up, something you'd be sacrificing, a young running back, without a doubt. Obviously, we have Shady who was signed, but the depth chart with Ivory and Shady, we got 29 and 30 year olds in the backfield. They, as much as I love Shady and I think he's going to be great moving forward over the next couple seasons, he's been our offense. I think they need to get younger, get a running back in there, and that's what you're going to be sacrificing if you were to trade the farm, is possibly getting a second or third round running back. That's something that would be sacrificed. So one last thing I do want to talk about before hanging up here. Got about 5 minutes left. Let me know what you think. Any questions that you want answered on the last 5 minutes. But one just quick little tidbit. If you've watched past Fandemoniums, I have talked about the big trade where the Eagles moved from 8 to 2 to get Carson Wentz. Another trade that I want, talking about how much the Bills are going to have to give up. Let's look at just last year's trade, just to even move up one position in the NFL draft. That would be the Chicago Bears last year, just moving up from 3rd to 2nd. I just want everyone to realize how much the Bills are going to have to move up and give up if they were to move up. Last year, they gave up, obviously, the 3rd overall pick to move over to 2nd while the 49ers were on the clock. So that was a swap right there. And they also had to give up 2/3, one in 2017, one in 2018, and a 4th in 2017. So that was 3 picks in the third and fourth round that they had to give up just to move up a spot while the 49ers were on the clock. Just what my point is, and I want of all of you fanatics to realize, is that moving up costs a decent amount. Even if it's just one spot, it's costly to move up in the NFL draft. You got to realize that. And when talking about possibly going to get these quarterbacks, we'll have to see. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, Pierre. I'm going to have to look at that. But I know about that Rams and Titans when they moved up, from 15, moving up in that year. And it was actually turned out to not be all that terrible of a move for them. They didn't have to give up as much as people previously had thought. But I think with the precedent that the Jets set this year, having to give up, obviously, their 1st and 3 second round picks, I think it's all about the now. I know I compare to other years, but I think the most important one and the top priority that you need to look at as a Bills fan for what the Bills need to give up, look at what has happened this year. And the Jets had to give up a ton, in my opinion, just to move up 3 spots in the NFL draft. It was costly for them, but they want to go get their guys. So I definitely understand that one. And I'm seeing a lot of comments from Kenneth talking about picking a guard. Yeah, it's another position that they would have to sacrifice if they were to move up in the NFL draft. And they could use it. You could always use guards. If you have like a multiple 2nd or 3rd round picks, always picking up somebody on the offensive line never hurts. It never hurts. One of the most obviously underrated positions in the NFL is the offensive line, and it's crucial, and we overlook it a lot as fans. But getting an offensive lineman is one of the most important things. And when you have that many picks, you always see when a team has a lot of picks, they always get their offensive lineman. And I think that's what the Bills are planning on doing if they do somehow end up keeping all their picks. But we'll see what happens there. Expect them to get a guard or two. Just fill that offensive line with talent. But with that being said, I'm going to wrap it up here. We'll see what happens. It's just amazing that we have a whole another month of this. If you notice, I didn't even talk about a quarterback today. I threw out the examples of Rosen and Baker Mayfield, just throwing them out there. But I didn't even get into their dynamics. I know there's a lot of other great Buffalo Fanatic shows that go into breaking down their film and looking at their pro days and breaking that down. So definitely go and check out all those different other accounts. But one thing I've known with the NFL draft, you can really be – it's still a month away, and I'll get into all those quarterbacks very, very soon. But if you start too soon talking about them, and I know the whole entire media – and a lot of other Buffalo Fanatic stuff has talked about it. So that's why I wanted to kind of stay away from them today, give something a little more refreshing in talking about, okay, if the Bills do want to go get a quarterback, where do they get to move up? Where is the best place for them to move up? So if next show, I'm definitely going to talk about the different quarterbacks options and who I think is the best. I've talked about it a little before on previous shows. So if you want a little preview, you can go and check those ones out. Go check out the other ones and we'll see what happens. I still think the Bills always seem to have surprised me, but I don't think there's going to be that much news over this next week. In my opinion, the Bills should and will wait till draft day to make this trade. But that's definitely up for debate, and we'll see what happens with them. Brandon Bean has seemed to surprise us a lot in just his short year here, so we'll see what happens. Thank you all for tuning into Fandemonium today. Make sure you give Buffalo Fanatics the like and go watch all the other great shows that we have here. It's truly amazing what Buffalo Fanatics is doing. I thank them, and they're doing awesome, putting all these different shows together for you guys to enjoy and be entertained by. So thanks for watching. I'll be back next week. That's all I got. I'm Joe Lorenzi, and of course, go Bills.